If you're a beginner who wants to start producing music, then you have found yourself in the right place. This video is going to quickly, easily, and best of all, cheaply walk you through all the software and hardware that you need to start producing great music on your computer. On this channel, we make weekly videos with music production tips and music marketing strategies. So if you want to level up either of those things, consider subscribing. Let's get right into it. Now, the two biggest concerns people usually have before they start producing music is that they're apprehensive that they can't bear the cost of it, and that their lack of real music theory knowledge will stop them from being able to produce good music. Fortunately, you don't have to spend a lot to begin creating incredible music, and I am going to show you a few tricks on how you can get started without that confusing music theory stuff. Now, the first thing you're going to need is, of course, a computer. Honestly, any modern-ish computer is going to be good enough to get you into music production. Now, in this video, I'm not going to get super deep into the tech specs of the computer you need, but I will show on screen some suggested minimum requirements, and I'm going to link a great article in the description that you can read through to see if your computer is good enough. Okay, now we're getting into it. You have a computer, but where and how do you actually start producing music? Well, you do that with a Digital Audio Workstation, or DAW for short. It aims to provide you with the recording, production, and mixing and mastering abilities of an analog studio. Okay, awesome. Now that we understand that, we're going to dive a little deeper into what a DAW actually is. Now, the music you hear on the radio may sound complicated, but they can all be simplified and broken down into their individual components. Songs are constructed by layering different sounds together and on top of one another. DAWs make it easy to take individual tracks and layer them. Now, there are tons of digital audio workstations. Also, I got a prize for whoever comments the correct amount of times I've said that word in this video. Now, the big question is, which DAW should I use? And they all have their pros and cons, but realistically, they allow you to do the exact same thing. So what we recommend is trying the demo version of the ones that we're about to recommend to find out which one works best for you. And of course, in the description, you can find links to download the demos of both of the DAWs I'm about to talk about. Now, there are multiple versions that you can buy of each DAW, and the more expensive versions offer more functionality as your needs increase as a new music producer. And you can easily upgrade at any time. But honestly, you can create some really good stuff on just the demo version alone. So I highly suggest you download that and get right into it. Now, if you are a new music producer, I really hope you're finding tons of value in this video. And I would really appreciate if you could smash that like button to show me some support. So thanks in advance for that. Let's go over both DAWs I recommend. The first one I'm going to talk about is FL Studio. This is a very popular DAW. It's what I actually first started in, and I do highly recommend it. FL Studio is kind of like the Apple product of DAWs. It's got the best looking interface, in my opinion, and it's the most familiar as far as programs go into relation to where roughly you'd find certain things like settings and how everything has a few tabs at the top and whatnot. Here are some prices on screen for if you do choose to upgrade. Now I'm gonna quickly go over the second DAW I recommend, which is Ableton. Ableton is the one that I use now, and in my opinion, it is much more straightforward. You don't have to mess with mixer routing, since every channel has its own mixer and effect script. And I know if you're a beginner, you don't understand those terms. In my personal opinion, it is easier to pick up and just produce. So which DAW should you pick? Well, here's not what you're gonna wanna hear, but honestly, just pick one, download it, and see if it works for you. There are thousands upon thousands of hours of resources and tutorials for both of these DAWs, so you'll easily be able to jump in and start producing no matter which one you pick. FL Studio is prettier. Ableton, in my opinion, is more straightforward. So download one and just start producing. Next up, we're gonna get into essential music production equipment. While every single person has their unique preferences, some equipment have become the industry standard for beginning producers. Real quick, before we do get into that, I just wanna say, when I start a new hobby, I personally like to just go all in. I like to start creating the highest quality content as quickly as possible. Time is the most valuable resource that we have. That's why, if possible, I really like to avoid wasting it. Take making these videos, for example. Almost right away, I instantly went and bought the right camera, the right lighting, the right lenses, and some great editing software. Did I need to? No. Did my videos instantly get 100 times better? In my opinion, yes. So it's like, why even waste the time? Now, not everyone is like that, and you might not have the funds available, and that is totally okay. But if you are, I have some fantastic recommendations that will help a beginner produce amazing quality music as quickly as possible. And honestly, it's not even gonna cost you that much. And everything I'm about to talk about in this video is linked in the description, sorted by budget for your convenience. Let's get into it. And in my opinion, almost as important as the DAW is the MIDI controller that you select to control it. A MIDI controller is an essential piece of music gear in today's home studio. In short, MIDI is the universal standard that allows for communication between physical hardware and the software. You can use this to control pretty much anything. And personally, it makes for a much faster workflow and I get much better ideas down. It's honestly like playing the real instruments without needing all the knowledge and for a fraction of the price. There are a lot of MIDI controllers, but if you are a beginner looking to start producing music right, here are my top three recommendations depending on your budget. Number one is the Akai MK2 Mini. This is the one I personally use. It's a 25 key MIDI keyboard with drum pads. I love this thing. It's a great price. I've had mine for years and it's still holding up, so I highly recommend this MIDI keyboard. Number two is the Akai Professional MPK-261. This one is for someone wanting to go all in right away. This is the 61 key semi-weighted MIDI keyboard controller. It has tons of pads, a great response time. It has mixer options that you can map to the software, RGB illuminated pads, 24 assignable Q-Link controllers, and this also includes Ableton Live Lite. So that's a little better than the demo version. If you buy this MIDI keyboard, you'll also get an upgraded version of that DAW. So I think that's a pretty great deal and something you should look into. My third is a budget option. This thing is great if you're just looking to wet your toes a little bit. Keep in mind, you'll probably want to be upgrading in the future, but for $60, the M-Audio KeyStation Mini is a great choice. That's it for MIDI keyboards. Take a note of which one you might want to look at. Next up on the list of essential gear for the beginner music producer is studio headphones. Studio headphones are headphones designed specifically for music production. Studio headphones differ from consumer and gaming headphones through their neutral sonic balancing. Without knowing what your song actually sounds like, you'll have all these imperfections. If you were to produce with, say, Beats headphones, for example, your bass would probably end up being really low when you play it on other systems, and that's because Beats headphones pump up the bass, which sounds really great when you're listening to music, but it's not so great when you're trying to create music that sounds good on all systems. So if you are wanting to produce music, you need some studio headphones. Another pro is they're a lot more portable than something like studio monitors, which is something that I'll get into a bit later. Here are three industry standard studio headphones that I recommend based on your budget. First up is the Audio Technica ATH-M50X. This is the pair to get. I love these things. They're praised by top audio engineers around the world. They're clear sound for studio, live, DJ, and personal use, and they have extreme clarity throughout all frequencies. Coming in at only $150, these things are great. Now, my budget pick is actually the little brother from the M50s, and that is the M30s. The M30s are awesome, and this is what I started with years ago, and for $70, these are an awesome pick. I mean, these are really flat sounding, which is exactly what you want. None of the frequencies are boosted, so you're gonna know exactly what the music you're creating sounds like. And yeah, these are just super easy to mix and produce on. Also, I do have these linked in the description, along with every other essential piece of music gear that I recommended. So based on your budget, you can open those all up in new tabs and get started right away. Now, later on, you might want to invest in some solid studio monitors, which are even better than headphones for mixing and producing. I'm not going to get into that in this video, but if you would like to purchase that, I have my top recommendation linked in the description for your convenience, but you can go so far with just studio headphones. So you can just stick with those for now. Now, we're not done yet. You have your computer, your banging new digital audio workstation, shiny new MIDI keyboard ready to be played, and your awesome true to sound studio headphones. And you're almost ready to start creating your first tracks. What an exciting time. Now let's get real for a second. Your first songs are gonna suck. They're really gonna suck. They're gonna be garbage. I gotta break it to you. I know, it's hard to hear. They're gonna be trash. Absolute disgusting pieces. And that's okay, that's part of the process. The goal is to just get 1% better with each track you complete. And with that, you'll be creating music you love in no time. And let me tell you, what a feeling that actually is. When you finally create that first track that you really, really love, I mean, can't even explain. But I am super stoked for you, and I'm gonna get into the last thing that I recommend. Number one, I'm gonna recommend a MIDI pack straight out of the gate. These things are awesome. Remember when I talked about that MIDI keyboard earlier? Well, some companies actually hire professional pianists to record MIDI progressions that you can download and drag directly into your track. And you'll see on screen how you can just drag and drop these. And you can assign any sound that you want to this MIDI. So I could choose a piano sound, for example. Or I could put this hard synth on it. Or I could do any number of things. The MIDI is a blank slate for any sound that you choose.